Hello, everyone. Welcome to Relationship Talk with Sharonda. My name is Sharonda Parker, and I am your host. And this is the day after my birthday. And I just want to personally tell everyone thank you for all of your prayers. Thank you for all of your visits. Thank you for your gifts. Thank you for your texts, your emails, your DMs, like literally any type of way that you could have reached me to communicate with me, you all did it. And if there was ever a example of loving somebody back to life, you all exemplified that yesterday. In literally everything from my wife group to my regular group to other women in business that are in the adult industry, just women in business, period. My church family, people who are just connected to me, even though I don't have a lot of immediate family, you know, like literally, the love was real yesterday. My children did an amazing job of making my birthday very special under the circumstances. So I personally want to tell you all, thank you. I also want to tell you all that there is a big difference in starting over and starting from scratch. I'm not starting from scratch. I'm just starting over. And I think sometimes it's all about the way we choose to look at things. You know, if you choose to look at things from a negative perspective, then a lot of times you will cloud your mind with negativity. But I'm not a negative person, so I'm not going to ever look at this from a negative perspective. Whoever God sends in my life, I'm going to love them. I'm going to reverence them. I'm going to serve them. I'm going to submit. I'm going to still be the same great woman who God created me to be. Because, you know, when you're in a public light, and you put something out so personal, like what I put out yesterday, you can expect feedback from literally everybody. And one thing that I know is that every woman is not a woman of God. And every woman do not have a personal relationship with God. And every woman does not understand what it means to love their husband, even in the midst of what's going on. I'm gonna get up every day and I'm gonna present my husband to the Lord. And I'm going to continue to ask for God's will to be done. Not Sharonda's will to be done, but God's will to be done. And I'm going to tell you why I'm saying God's will to be done. Because I don't know what the future may hold. But I'm going to continue to say, Lord, let your will be done. Does that mean that the person that we're guaranteed to be back? No, it does not. But whatever God's will is, I'm saying, Lord, let your will be done. And that's where I'm at with it. So I don't have anything bad to say. I don't have these stories. You know, I didn't have a bad husband. I've been married 22 years. I didn't have a bad husband. So I'll never put a narrative out there that my husband was a bad husband. Now, will I say these last 2 months been hell? Oh, yeah, these last 2 months been hell. These last 2 months then opened my eyes up. These last 2 months, I don't even know the person that I was sleeping next to. But can I say that over the 22 years that my husband has not been a great husband and father? I can't say that. So that's why I can wish him well. That's why I can say, I just want you to be better. I want you to get help. I want you to do whatever it is that's going to make you happy. Okay? So now that I've gotten that out the way, baby, we got a whole lot of learning to do. This teaching going to go on. What I do, I'm going to continue to do what I do. Okay? And this is what I do. I am the sex toy queen. I am in the adult industry. And I'm just going to let you know something. I've been plugging up and recharging more these last couple of weeks than I done did in a long time. I pulled out toys that I had forgot about. Because, you know, when you moving and you start finding stuff, you be like, oh, shit, I forgot I had this. Shit, I forgot I had that. Let me charge this one up. God damn it. I remember what that one did. So I have, especially the little toy, the red toy with the tongue on it that lick, and then the end of it got the damn bullet on it that vibrate. Oh, Shit. I wore myself out when I, with that one last night for my birthday. I was like, oh, I'm going to get some mouth, goddammit. I'm going to get some mouth. And I got some. But anyway, y'all know Labor Day is coming up. And these are called like grab bags. These are things that you can grab that are intended for you to be able to take and throw in your luggage to be able to have a great time. This one is the newest one on the market. This one is the Sexual Adventures Kit. This one is going to have your handcuffs, your blindfold, your feather, your bullet, your cock ring, all of your suggestion cords. All of that is going to be in here. Yes, this is on the website. Then this one is sex therapy. Okay, sex therapy came out a few years ago. Okay, but we just restocked it again. Sex therapy is going to have your coupon vouchers. It's going to have your clitoral stimulator. It also has handcuffs, but it has rose petals and a not a vibrating cock ring, but a regular cock ring, because this is intended to be more of a romance type of kit, whereas this is intended to be more of a turnip type of kit, okay? So we have these two, and then we have, of course, our grab bags. Take control. This is going to be for my people who are into the kink, the bondage, the BDSM, the chains and whips, the spanking, the, you know, all of this hardcore type of stuff. That's who this for. Blowjob, self-explanatory. You're going to be sucking a lot of dick with this one, okay? Just the two of us. This is just a little bit of something for everybody. Kind of mild, real good to give to a couple that's getting married, people who just kind of getting off into the adult, you know, all of these toys and stuff. It's not too invasive. It's not too, when you pull out the stuff, you won't be offended by it. You know, it's not something that'll run the person out the room, okay? And then we have the erotic one. Now, the erotic one is going to be your massage oil. It's going to be your vibrator, tickets, handcuffs, things like that. So, I'm just showing you all of these because, of course, Labor Day is around the corner. A lot of you all are about to take your final vacation. Final. This is normally the last one, you know, before we get back into the groove of things with school starting back and all of this kind of stuff. But I have it here so that you can come and take your pick and decide what you are going to throw in your luggage. All of these here are available. And guess what? They all the same price. Every last one of them are $29.99. Okay? They are here at the PPG store. Yes, we open at 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. So, come here, shop. Come see me. Yes, I'm in a good place, y'all. I am. I'm really in a good place. And like I say, I can't tell you all thank you enough. People that know me personally, y'all know that I don't have parents. Y'all know that I don't have siblings. I don't have a lot of family. My family was just never one. They had a lot of kids. My grandmother only had 5 grandkids, and one of them passed last year. So it's only 4 of us, and I'm the oldest girl. It's another girl and 2 other boys. So I'm just trying to give you the understanding that my family is very, very, very small. But let me tell you something. My family in Christ, the people who God have put in my life, all of my nieces, because I'm the auntie, all of my nieces that God has given me, my church family. See, a lot of times we put a lot of emphasis on what we don't have and who's no longer here and what's not available to us. But I think if we start taking the time to start appreciating what God has actually given us, we will be in a much better place. In other words, you know, when my mom died, I was like, you know, I felt this emptiness, right? But I remember God sending this lady at church that would hug me every Sunday, hug me and my children every Sunday at church. And for Mother's Day, I would give her a gift. And, you know, Christmas, I would always give her a gift. And I just, one day I had to tell God, thank you for, even though this is not my mother, thank you for giving me this woman that hugs me and my children every Sunday. So sometimes we just got to learn how to say thank you for what we do have. My children did an amazing job, y'all. They got me tickets to the Laurel Plantation this weekend. Oh, I didn't tell y'all, I hit a deer last night at my car. Yeah, I wrecked my Audi last night coming from the restaurant. But, you know, even with that, it is well. It is well. I ended up taking a lift here to the store. The adjuster is coming out, and my car will be going to Audi to get repaired, and they will be providing me with a rental car. So I am fine. Y'all, when I tell you all is well, all is well. Hallelujah, hallelujah, anyhow. Count it all joy. However you wanna say it, it is well. It is well with Sharonda Parker, baby. It is well. You all be blessed. You all enjoy your Thursday. Again, thank you all for the love and support. It was greatly appreciated. I love y'all. Thank you.